Hello and welcome to the CSV Mapping tutorial. So you're probably wondering, what is CSV Mapping? Well, you may have current systems that hold your customers, products, equipment, purchase orders, sites and contact data, and you might want to bring that over to Clik. Now currently what you have to do is you have to use our CSVs, and you can't use the CSVs that might be exported from those databases. However, this brings in the CSV Mapping, so you can map the fields from your CSVs from other databases to Clik's fields. And then that will be what we call a CSV template, and you can use it again and again. And this will save you copying and pasting from one spreadsheet to another spreadsheet. So a bit of a time-saving exercise. But also it could be used for potentially suppliers' price lists as well. So for example, a supplier says they've changed all their prices and you need to quickly import that in. You've now got a mapping, so you've mapped all the fields before with their original spreadsheet, so then you don't have to go and copy and paste into the product CSV file into Clik all the time. So I'm going to show you how to create a CSV mapping template. So what we do is we go on to Tools at the top here, we go to CSV Import, and we go to Setup Predefined Imports. So as you can see, I've created one called My Supplier CSV. And all you need to do to create one is click on New, and I've called it My Supplier CSV, and the product type is product. And you can select, obviously, purchase invoice, equipment, contact, company or site if you wish to do different types of CSV mapping. So from the supplier's spreadsheet, their columns are supplier's price, product code and supplier name. And all I've had to do is literally click on Clik column here and select it. So for example, I know supplier's price is default supplier price in Clik. We know that the product code is product code. It's got a little plus sign to say that's a duplicate field. What that means is it will check the duplicate fields when you start importing the prices in. And if there is a duplicate, it won't put that in. And you've also got supplier's name, and we call it default supplier. And this particular one would be just one. So once you're happy with this, you can press OK. You can then go to Tools, you can go to CSV Import, and then you'll now get Imports. And then you can click on Product, click on My Supplier CSV, and then you get into the Product Import section. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on Import at the top, and I'm going to go to Update Duplicate Records, because we don't want to just create new records, we just want to update it, and we're going to click OK. We're going to find the spreadsheet, which is My Supplier's price list, press open, and that's going to bring it all over. And all it's going to do is literally update this base price here, which is what the new base price is for that particular product. Once you're happy with it, you just click on save. That will save that base price for that particular supplier on there. So I'm going to close that, and that would be it for a product import. But I want to go further and just talk about how we might use it as well. And we're going to go through sort of an equipment mapping exercise so you know how to do it straight from the top. So what we need is obviously our previous database had lots of equipment, and we want to put that into Clik. Now the CSV, it means we'd have to copy and paste between that CSV file and the default Clik product CSV file. However, we don't want to do that. We just want to go forward. We want our own CSV template. So what we're going to do is we're going to click on Tools, we're going to go to CSV Import, we're going to go to Setup Predefined Imports, and I'm going to click New, and I'm going to put in My Equipment CSV. And the type is going to be Equipment. And as you can see, it's brought over User Columns and Clik Columns. But in this case, you'll see that they're just matching both at the moment. And that's because what we haven't done is we haven't read the CSV headers on the other database's CSV file. And that's what we're going to do now. So we're going to click on Read CSV Headers. We're going to say yes. And we're going to go all the way down to My Equipment from another database. Click on Open, and that's brought them in. Now it has matched some of them, which is really nice and really handy, but we need to match the rest. So as you can see, from my other database, the user column equipment, it was called Equipment Description, but in Clik, it's just going to be called Description. Location, in Clik, we actually call it Plant Location. Equipment Number, that's going to be Reference, so we just click on Reference. Is Fire Alarm On? Well, we need a user field with Fire Alarm On. Actually, we're just going to call it Past. So it'd be Past. And then we've got site reference, which would be site reference. Now you'll notice that you've also got these little icons next to it. So duplicate fields, and that just means that duplicate field means that it will be checking for duplicate fields, so they can't go in or go in duplicates. So it's just checking that they match basically when you actually do the proper import. And then you've also got a link. So in this particular one, an equipment CSV, it must link to a site description or a site reference, could possibly be a site reference as well. But in this case, it's going to be site description. Okay, so you'll also notice is fire alarm, and we used a user field. And what we've also got is converters. So if you've got a user field, you might need to convert it. So is fire alarm on is a yes or a no answer, and so is passed. So what I can do is I can click on the three dots here, and I can click new, and I could say, I know that in my CSV, it's yes, and it goes to the true. So it's either a true or false. And if I do new, it's going to be no, and that's going to be false. So that's what you're looking at if you're going to do a value converter. So once you're happy with that, we can click on OK, and it will say that it's got that converter in there. So I can press OK now on this, and then I can start thinking about importing my equipment CSV with that particular CSV spreadsheet, so the one that's come out of that other database. So all I need to do is go to Tools, go to CSV Imports, click on Imports, select Equipment, in this case, my equipment CSV, click on Import, and in this case, I am going to go by serial number. And actually, we could do site reference or site description because they're both linked. In this case, I'm just going to do site reference. Going to press OK, find my equipment from another database. That's going to give me all the equipment in there. Now, in this case, because I have done it before, it's told me that there are a couple of lines where there's no action taken because they've already been imported in. So it's found the duplicates and is not going to do anything with them. That's fine. I can click on the cross and I can just save the rest. So I can just click on save here, and that's put all of my equipment in from my other database into Clik using their CSV file. So we click on exit, and that's that done. And now what you need to do is you could just use that again. So if you got some more data out of that other database that you need to put in for equipment, you could go to Tools, CSV Import, go to Imports, go to Equipment, and then use that particular My Equipment CSV again. Okay, that's really it for CSV mapping. Thank you very much for listening.